Good morning, students. Our today's topic is compound interest. You might have come across statement like 1 year interest for fixed deposit in the bank at 9% per annum or saving account with interest 5% per annum. Interest means interest is extra money paid by institution like the banks or post offices on money deposited with them. Interest is also paid by people when they borrow money. We already know how to calculate the simple interest. Means whenever you borrow some money from your friend or relative or a bank, you have to give interest. So you might have heard this word interest. We use the simple interest. Sometimes bank takes compound interest from us when we borrow the money from bank. Now we will see the just example of simple interest. Like a sum of rupees 10,000 is borrowed at a rate of interest 15% per annum for 2 years. Find the simple interest on the sum and the amount to be paid at the end of 2 years. So our sum is 10,000 and rate of interest is 15% per annum, and how many days a person have used that money, that is 2 years, means number of years is 2. So on 100, interest charges for 1 year is rupees 15. For 100 rupees, interest is 15 rupees. Then for 10,000, so we can calculate like this: 15 upon 100 into 10,000 equal to 1500. For 100 rupees it is rupees 15, and for 10,000 it is rupees 1500. So interest for 2 years, so this is the interest for 1 year. So 1 year interest is 1500, and 2 years interest is 1500 into 2 equal to 3000. Now amount to be paid at the end of 2 years is principal plus interest. So principal is 10,000 and interest is 3,000, that is addition of both is 13,000. So this is the interest. Now you have to try this sum example. Find the interest and amount to be paid on rupees 15,000 at 5% per annum after 2 years. This is the similar to this one. So you try this one. Now, how to calculate the compound interest? Compound interest is different from the simple interest. Means, just we will see one example, that is, one boy, he is saying that my father has kept some money in the post office for 3 years. Every year the money increases as more than the previous years. Means, a boy's father keep money in the bank, and every year post office gives him some kind of interest, and every year's money is increases than previous year. Now we have some money in bank. His friend asked him that we have some money in the bank, every year some interest is added to it, which is shown in the passbook. This interest is not the same each year, it increases. Means she is asking like every year the sum is amount it changes, interest amount changes or a principal amount changes. Normally the interest paid to be charged or charged never simple. The interest is calculated on the amount of the previous years. Means whenever we take we fix amount in the bank, then every year the amount increases because there is interest is added, and then next year that total amount, means suppose we have fixed 10,000 in the bank and we got a 1500 interest, rupees 1500 interest on it. So our next principal is 11,500, and then we will get interest on 11,500. So this is a kind of compound interest. how to calculate this one, compound interest. Let us see here one example. A sum of rupees 20,000 is borrowed by Hina for 2 years at the interest of 8%, compounded annually. Find the compound interest and the amount she has to pay at the end of 2 years. Hina borrowed 20,000 rupees of interest 8%. And 8% interest compound annually, and she has taken that money for 2 years. Now Aslam asked the teacher whether this means that they should find the interest year by year. Aslam asking they should find the interest year by year. The teacher said yes and asked him to use the following steps. First step is find the simple interest. First of all, we have to find out the simple interest. We know the formula. Let the principal for the first year is P1, that is rupees 20,000, and 8% means 20,000 into 8 upon 100, that is 1600. So this is the second P1 principal. Second means second years, because 20,000 plus 1600, that is total of these two amounts is a next year's principal. Then find out the amount which will be paid or received. This becomes a principal for the next year. Means addition of these two, principal plus simple interest, addition of both two is the principal for the second year. Means 21,600. 21,600, that is the second principal for second year. Again find the interest on the sum for another year. Means this is now our principal is changed, and 8% of that principal is 1,728. Next step is, so our P2 plus simple interest. Simple P2 is 21,600 and simple interest is 1,728 rupees. So addition of both is 23,322. The total interest is, first year's interest is 1600 and second year's interest is 1728. So total interest is 3,328. Now Rita asked whether the amount would be different for simple interest. The teacher told her to find the simple interest for 2 years. Means this is the compound interest for 2 years, and this is the, now this by last year method, means simple interest method is PRN. P means principal, R means rate, and N means number of years. PRN divided by 100 equal to. So 20,000 into 8 into 2. This is the formula for a simple interest. So the amount is 3,200. Look, compare these two amounts. First amount is, compound interest amount is 3,328. And simple interest amount is 3,200. So this amount is, compound interest amount is greater than the simple interest. Rita said that when compound interest was used, Hina would pay 128 more. So this, whenever we compare these two amounts, then 128 rupees is more of compound interest. Let us look at the difference between the simple interest and compound interest. So look this one, this chart. Here is a, suppose year, principal, interest and year end amount. This is simple interest and this is under compound interest. First year, suppose principal is 100, both 4, and interest is 10%. So our end amount is, year end amount is 110. Here is also 110. Now second year principal is also same under simple interest, rate is also same, but here is interest is 10%. So our Principal is here 110, means this total of this compound simple interest, and whatever we got the total amount, that will be our principal for next year. And 10% of this one is 11 rupees. So look here is year end amount is 120.